Okay, on to chapter 3. Looks like we go from ice to Asian scenery. Oil storage, helicopters.
We're out of fuel again!
We're damn lucky to have made it this far with that army, Talius. Speaking of luck, how the hell did I end up in another flying machine?
You realize that running across that abandoned oil storage along the way was a miracle, right? And if we don't find some more oil soon, this helicopter's gonna turn into one hell of a heavy glider.
Stop panicking. There's a platform straight ahead. Prepare for landing.
There's nothing here. Head directly to that oil storage.
And scrape up whatever oil's left in the barrels. I know. Like we did last time, the time before that. Look, it's the units we left in the northern waters. They found us.
It must have been hot back in that ice if these are all that's left. We've only got enough oil to fly to the nearest platform.
My gut tells me we're on a collision course with disaster. You notice anything particular about our luck these past few days?
We'd better use the radar skill, just to be on the safe side.
Those anti-air towers would have shot this helicopter down in no time flat.
Being tailed again. Now we've got enemies both front and back.
Not like we have a choice of which way to go. Actually, I can scout the enemy's defenses from the helicopter. We just need to turn back quickly if it gets hot. We've got backup, though it looks like they could use some backup themselves.
We won't make it to the platform, but we have to help them.
The entire area is mined.
Going straight through isn't an option. I could lose my entire fleet here. We need to recon.
Again, contact them before... What the hell? Did they jack a repair vessel?
They can make it through the mines. That vessel will patch up their hulls as they go. We can bypass the minefield and trade some punches, or cut straight through it. Both ways are risky.
Thank you.
there are so many mines. I wonder how they get around without blowing themselves up. Don't they have anything better to do than follow us?
We've stolen their tech. If we get back to base with it, they'll lose their advantage. I'd be peeved too.
Yeah, they're nervous. It's okay.
Mayday! Mayday!
Can you land this thing?
Trust me. There's no way we miss the ground.
Damn it! I'm hit!
Just hold on. Village in sight. Please! We need help! He's wounded!
You come with big guns, trample our crops, and now ask for help? It is an interesting way of asking.
We can pay you back with oil, as much as you want.
Oil? What do I need your oil for? There won't be more fish in ocean if you pour oil in it. Rice won't grow faster if you water it with gasoline.
It's fuel, technology.
You have nothing I need, but every acorn harbors a leafy oak tree in its shell. I will help you.
Oh yes, I'm gonna start turning.
I managed to assemble a working radio from this garbage. We've got contact with the sharks.
Status report. The northern rain forced us out, and we've retreated to an unexplored region south by southwest of there. We came across some abandoned oil extraction machinery. Commander, it seems that oil was drilled here before the war.
It's good to hear your voice again. But let's get back to the oil. The news couldn't have come at a better time. Our oil supplies have almost run out. Begin extraction immediately.
Copy that. We've got the enemy behind our back, but I won't fail you this time. You'll get all this oil, down to the very last drop. There's some oil in this storage. We've also got more space to store pumped oil. Storage goes to the enemy, and we're out of room to store extra oil too.
should have.
Wonderful. Bring that oil to us. Now I want you to clear those filthy tramps from the region. They're in the way.
Commander, they don't need the oil and don't present any threat.
Everybody needs oil. No matter what tales they tell you, execute the order.
I repeat, they pose no threat to our oil. Commander, we owe these people. They helped us.
Oh, you must have been hit on the head harder than I thought. They're just feeding you with lies about how peaceful they are. Open fire.
I can't do that to them. That's a negative, sir.
I'll talk to you after you return to base. Sergeant, take command. This region must be cleared.
Belay that, Sergeant. We're soldiers, not butchers. Everyone hold your positions. Comrades, this is a war, and we're already up to our necks in blood, both ours and our enemies. But we also have to remember why we're here in the first place. Where is the line which you dare not cross? Do you believe that oil is worth spilling innocent blood? As soldiers, it's our duty to fight so others may live. But we turn our guns on the people we should have been defending. If you believe this is wrong, then it's time to decide. Save this village. But I need you all to understand. You'll have to fight your former comrades in order to do it.
What the hell are we waiting for? Let's stop, Commander, from burning them alive.
There's no turning back now. All units under my command, change identifiers. If they're not with us, they're against us.
I guess that was a long mission. The sea dragon, I guess.
There is an ancient proverb. The hand that holds a rake can still change history. And my people have something better than rakes. We never used it, but there was a military base here once. Take these platforms and the armory.
Kevin, I will forgive your foolishness if you give up. This is your last chance. And if you won't surrender, you have no one to blame but yourself. I've sent a nuclear submarine to your position.
Who would you blame?
I've made my choice. No, well. Oil is not thicker than
commander.
Blood. Over. Excellent. If we build defensive towers around the platforms, we can hold this village against attacks.
Coming.
Off we go. The helicopters are in the air.
Attention! The submarine has resurfaced.
Thank you.
to the bottom.
The commander won't let it go. The sharks know where to find you. We've put you at risk once, and I won't let it happen again. You need to evacuate the villagers to safety.
Follow the sunset for 5 days, and you will reach a bay. Quiet and safe. They will not find us there, but our junk boats are slow and unprotected.
The sea dragons will cover you. We owe you for helping us. We need to clear the way for the wooden junks. We'll move ahead and the villagers will follow us later. These platforms are dangerous for them.
On your six, we're being followed.
Thank you.
We are splitting into two groups. A chance taken for half is better than no chance at all.
You're not making things easy for me. Either I scatter my forces or sit between you.
We'll do everything we can to help you make it out of here. Villagers.
Damn it! You promised to protect them!
To move on. safe or not, we are going to the next platform.
Faster!
Thank you.
our trail.
To the next platform, or they'll catch you.
Oh, well, lost one more.
The rest of the villagers alive. That's all we can do.
That's a good version. Yeah, they definitely can repair it. We'll be right back.
boats back together.
There.
It's over for you. Now you're safe. But we can't relax just yet. The hardest part is still ahead of us. It seems we'll have to go all out and defeat the commander in his own territory.
Either we finish him, or he finishes us.
When the hailstorm comes, both a warrior and a wise man shelter under the same roof. I am coming with you, and old Shuang never comes with empty hands.
Oh, I thought the bell turned to like nuke silo site or something. And that does chapter 3 for us. Time for a break. Didn't go as well as I thought for that last one, but made it.